Gananam tva ganapatigam havamahe kavim kavinam upamashravastamam jeshtharajam brahmanam brahmanaspatana shrunvan utibhissidasadhanam Shri Mahaganadhipataye Namaha Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnuhu Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Om. Dear friends, we have to read this 29th shloka today. In the last class we completed the 28th. And I think we just read out that Samoham Sarva Bhuteshu, we just read out that shloka.
Yes.
We have to see the meaning. Meaning of the shloka also I have to explain. Then the overall context is, we are seeing the philosophy of bhakti. With reference to this attainment of moksha, of course jnana is the highest path. But then those who are not able to go to that level, even if it is karma yoga, that is what we saw in that 28th shloka, that is sannyasa yoga yuktatma. For the word sannyasa yoga, the meaning given is karma yoga. Sannyasascha asau mat samarpanataya karmatvadi yogascha. So that is what Shankaracharya explained. Other commentators also have explained. The sannyasa yoga is karma yoga. Karma yoga is one method. Devotion. And devotion, again, it need not be a very ostentatious devotion. It can be very, very simple devotion. What is required is your bhakti there, your intention. That is what is most important there, and not the amount of material you procure and then an amount of offering you give and all that. So these are this is what we have been seeing. And similarly, this present shloka is telling about samoham sarvabhuteshu name dveshyosti napriyaha. The avatarika was saying, the question was, if you are favoring your devotees only, does it not mean that you are somebody who is partial to your own devotees and then you are harming other, not bothered about other people? So are you, it means that the God again is a raga dvesha one, somebody who is having raga, somebody is having dvesha. So that is why, to avoid that sort of attribution or that sort of imputation, this particular shloka is coming, that is samoham sarvabhuteshu name dveshyosti napri. We can read it again. Let us read it. Samoham sarvabhuteshu
samoham sarvabhuteshu
name dveshyosti napriyah
name
dveshyosti napriyah ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya
ye bhajanti tumam bhaktya
mayite teshu chapyaham
mayite teshu chapyaham.
So this shloka I have to explain. Samaha aham sarvabhuteshu. Sarvabhuteshu, for all the beings. Bhuteshu actually is in saptami vibhakti. Sarvabhuteshu samaha. So it is a idiom, it is the Sanskrit idiom is like that. For all the beings, I am samaha. I am equal. Sama means equal. This word sama we have come across earlier also. Samadrushti. Pandita samadarshinaha. What is that other line? There is some other line also. Sama there refers to the Brahma. So refers to Brahma. Panditaha samadarshinaha. Shunichaiva shvapakecha panditaha samadarshinaha. There the word sama was explained to mean that sama means Brahma. That Shuddha Chaitanyam which is there in everything. So that is the meaning here also, which is given by other, the commentators. Samaha tulyaha aham sadrupena spurana rupena ananda rupena. This three aspects, that is what is called sat, chit and ananda. These three are common. These are the aspects of the supreme being. And these are the aspects which are manifest in all beings. And the only difference is, this being is having a nama and rupa. If you remove this nama and rupa, the other three things are common. The other three things, that is sat, chit and ananda, these are common for all the beings. So that is how I am equally evident and all. I am equally illumining the antahkarana of every being. I am equally giving all their satta, spurti and ananda. But then it depends on their antahkarana. Their antahkarana, if it is a pure antahkarana, he will think about me. If it is not a pure antahkarana and if he is bothered about various other things, he will not think about me. So, that antahkarana is his own business. So, antahkarana and then his body mind complex, that is form and name belong to him, whereas satta, spurti and ananda belongs to Brahman. So I am equal to all. So that is what he is saying, samaha aham sarvabhuteshu name dveshyah asti. Dveshyah is something, one who deserves hatred. Dveshyah, dvesha is hatred. Dveshyah is one who deserves hatred. Dvesha is different from dveshya. Then dveshyah, I don't have anybody who deserves hatred. From my point of view, there is nobody who deserves hatred. Name dveshyah asti na priyah. Because these things, raga, dvesha, these are the antahkarana dharmas. And in Shuddha Chaitanya, there is no antahkarana. When we are talking about the Shuddha Brahman, there is no antahkarana there. So it is only when there is antahkarana, say when you are thinking about some sort of functional God who is recording all your good deeds and your bad deeds, like at the level of religion. At the level of religion, we all have some functional God. So at that functional God, he has got some system. There is a big machinery, there is a big network under him, and in that machinery, there is some machinery to count your good deeds and also to note down your bad deeds. So, but when you are talking about the Supreme Brahman, there is no such machinery as such, there is no antahkarana as such. So, that is how, name dveshya asti name priyah. Then, ye bhajanti tu maam bhaktya. Those who bhajanti, bhajanti, here it can mean actually worship is one meaning, very very common meaning is worship. So here one commentary which is given is dharma charanam kurvanti, those who perform or those who follow the path of dharma. So those people, and also mam bhaktya bhajanti, and also devoted to me, they have to do their dharma, they have to do their karma according to say whatever is the ordained say manner. And then they should also have devotion to me. So that maam bhaktya, mayi te, so they are in me. Because they are in that brahmatma bhavana. Mayi te means they are in that brahmatma bhavana. Teshu cha api aham. I am in them. I am equally evident in their antahkaranas. I am equally indwelling their antahkaranas. I am illumining their antahkaranas in the same manner. So that is the general meaning. This sloka is rather simple. The basic point is Ishvara is equal to all. Ishvara is equal to all. So let us see the bhashyam. Samaha tulyaha aham sarvabhuteshu.
Samaha tulyaha aham sarvabhuteshu.
Name dveshyaha asti.
Name dveshyaha asti.
Na priyaha.
Na priyaha.
Samaha means tulyaha, equal. Of course, Shankaracharya here has not given the meaning. But from the earlier context, we see that sama. Nirdosham hi samam brahma. There is another line. Nirdosham hi samam brahma is one. Pandita samadarshinaha is one line. In all those contexts, the word sama is explained as meaning, as referring to Brahman. So that is what we have to see. Nirdosham hi samam brahma. There also, this samam is that brahma which is nirdosham, that which is untouched by any of these activities of this punya or papa or any such thing. Because it is of the nature of Shuddha Chaitanya, it is untouched by any of these fruits of any action. So that is the meaning. So samaha tulyaham sarvabhuteshu, and then I do not have any dveshya, somebody who deserves hatred, or na priyaha. Then agnivadaham durasthanam yatha agnihi,
durasthanam yatha agnihi,
shitam na apanayati,
shitam na apanayati,
samipam upasarpatam apanayati,
samipam upasarpatam apanayati,
tatha aham bhaktan anugrunhami,
tatha aham bhaktan anugrunhami,
na itaran. Okay, so he is giving an example, giving an example of agni. Agni is there. Agni is totally neutral, it is totally impartial, it does neither likes you nor dislikes you. If you go near, it will give you warmth. If you touch, it will burn you. If you go near, it will give you warmth. If you are away, it is just not bothered about you. So likewise, like Agni, aham, durasthanam yatha agnihi shitam na apanayati. If you are far away, this shitam na apanayati, it is not taking away your, apanayati means to take away. Apanaya, nayati means to lead, isn't it? Apanayati means to take away. Durasthanam shitam na apanayati, it doesn't take away or remove. Apanayati means to remove. It doesn't remove your say Shitam, the cold. You are shivering and then when you go near the, say, hearth only, it will give you some warmth. So if you are far away, sitting far away from this fireplace, it will not give you warmth. So it's like that. Then Samipam Upasarpatam. Samipam Upasarpatam means for those who go near. Upasarpatam, for those who go near. Apanayati, it removes that cold. Tatha aham bhaktan anugrunhami ne itaran. Likewise, I say favor or I give some boons or blessings to those who come to me. And then if somebody is not even thinking about me in this antahkarana, naturally he will go according to his own karma. Not that God is going to disfavor them, not that God is going to punish them for not coming to them. They will go according to their own karma. So what we have to remember here is, it is not as though God is favoring those who go near Him. God will punish them who don't go near Him. It is not like that. Those who just don't go near Him, this is the attitude of the Mimamsakas. We have to remember that Mimamsakas, there is a very strong school in olden days. That Mimamsaka school believed that you are just not bothered about, say God. You need not worry about God at all. This is all something like just a transaction. You do yajna, you have to jolly well get, swargam. And then jolly well that Indra is supposed to give you some benefits. So this was the thinking at that time. At that time, if you see, this Mimamsaka thinking was, you can do some yajna and go to swarga irrespective of God or irrespective of Brahma, irrespective of anything. So that was the attitude of those hardcore Mimamsakas. So it is almost like dismissing, God. On one hand, you are worshipping so many gods, and then you are again, demanding, yes, this is my right, I have to jolly well come there. So it is like that. So, at that time, that we have to keep in mind, the whole background we have to keep in mind. So here what he says is, it is not as though I favor only those who come to me. Those who don't come to me also, they will get their, karma phala, according to their karma. If that man is doing something, some loka sangraha, if that man is doing some good deeds, naturally he will get good, karma, good result, depending on that karma. Whether he loves me or not loves me, he will get his karma. He will get his karma phala. Then, what is the context we are seeing? We are seeing the context of somebody who is also a karma yogi and also a bhakta, isn't it? In the earlier slokas also, we have seen, somebody who is doing his karma and who is also a bhakta. Karma, upasana, samuchayam. This is what we have been seeing. Not jnana karma samuchaya. Jnana karma samuchaya can never take place. Karma, upasana, samuchaya can take place. So this is the sort of karma, upasana, samuchaya context which we are seeing, isn't it? So in that context, if they come to me, there is some extra benefit. That is karma plus upasana, it gives you extra result. So this is what we have seen throughout that 8th chapter and early, 9th chapter also. Karma plus upasana leads to that Brahmaloka also, and from where there is no punaravruti. All those things we have read. So that is how, ye bhajanti tumam bhaktiya maite teshu chapyaham. So here, tathaham bhaktan anugrunhami na itaran. So that is those people who come like that, they come up to this Brahmaloka and then they attain moksha. So that is what we have to see. Another commentator, that is Madhusudana Saraswati, gives another example also. Example of light. For example, Savitra Prakashaha Swachhe Darpanada Veva Abhivyajyate, he says. That is, Savitra Prakashaha means Savita is Surya. Savitra Prakashaha means the sunlight. Sunlight is equal to everybody. Sunlight is, it is just falling on everybody. So if you have a clean mirror, it will reflect the sunlight. If it is not a clean mirror, suppose you take some opaque substance and then some sort of dull dark surface, it will not reflect the sunlight. So like that, I will illumine a good antahkarana, I will shine on a good antahkarana in a favorable manner. If it is a bad antahkarana, okay, antahkarana it is shining, the light is falling, there is no doubt about it, but there is no reflection of that. So that is the meaning here. He gives that example. Samopi swachhe bhakta chitte abhivyajyamanaha. So if he is a bhakta, it falls in a slightly, the reflection is in a different way. So it like in the case of a pure mirror. So, okay. ये भजन्ति तु माम ईश्वरम
भक्त्या
मयि ते स्वभावत एव न मम रागनिमित्तं मयि न मम रागनिमित्तं मयि वर्तन्ते. सो दोस् हू वर्शिप मी भक्त्या मयि ते स्वभावत भक्त्या मयि ते स्वभावत एव. सपोज इट इज देयर नेचर, इट इज देयर नेचर टू डू भक्ति टू मी. And bhakti also is another thing. Bhakti is also related to jnana. Jnani, it does not mean jnani totally dismisses bhakti. Jnani can also be a great bhakta. So for example, this Madhusudana Saraswati, who wrote great doctrinal books like Advaita Siddhi. Advaita Siddhi is a very great doctrinal text. I have mentioned this thing earlier also. He wrote to refute the dualists. The dualists had written a very huge work called Nyayamrutam by bringing all the, what is called Navya-Nyaya, all the Navya-Nyaya syllogisms and all the Navya-Nyaya methodology they have brought, and then they tried to denounce this non-dual philosophy. At that time, so if the opponent is a sort of kung fu master, I should also learn some kung fu, isn't it? I can't fight him in some Indian style or some other style. I should also learn some kung fu. So likewise, the Advaitins also, they learned that Navya Nyaya. Otherwise, Advaita does not much bother about Nyaya. That is logic. It only talks about Shruti, what is that? Shruti Matas Tarkonu Sandhiyatam. So, you take that Tarka which is useful for interpretation of the text. So, you take that sort of Tarka and don't go into too many details, because Tarka itself is a construct of human mind. So, that is our approach. So, that is why when those people brought all that Navya-Nyaya methodology, Madhusudana Saraswati is one man who studied again that Navya-Nyaya methodology. Of course, these people, they were, even today, if you go to Sringeri and places like that, they study this Navya-Nyaya very, very thoroughly. Because at some level, there should be somebody who will be able to explain the doctrine. Who will be able to explain the doctrine, who will be able to say, if somebody says, no, 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 this is wrong, this man should be able to say, explain properly. So, even today, of course, they are learning. So, Madhusudana Saraswati, in that context, he wrote a huge book called Advaita Siddhi to counter that Nyayamrutam. And that Advaita Siddhi is as hardcore as that Nyayamrutam. Hardcore means very tough, phraseology. You and I cannot understand it. There is another book called Khandana Khandakadhyaya. Khandana Khandakadhyaya by another writer called Sriharsha. It is an equally tough text, and there are hardly any teachers who can teach that book now. So, but anyway, such Madhusudana Saraswati, he was a great bhakta. He was a very great Krishna bhakta. So, like that, a jnani does not mean that jnani discards bhakti. Jnani is also a bhakta. So, here, these people, it becomes a swabhava. So, that is where we digressed. Svabhavata eva mayi bhakti, say mayi bhaktim kurvanti. That is by nature, because he knows the supreme reality and he loves that. For example, Madhusudana Saraswati, he loved that Krishna, particularly this Bala Krishna. So like that, so you have got your own favorite deity. So svabhavata eva na mama raga nimittam mayi vartante. It is not as though I love them, they love me. Na mama raga nimittam. It is not as though I have this raga, dvesha, and that is how I love them. They love me so much, and then they are in me. Teshu cha apyaham. Swabhavata eva varte. Na itareshu. Na itavata. Teshu dveshaha mama. So they are in me, it has been told. Then teshu cha apyaham. I am also in them. Swabhavata eva varte. Naturally I will be there. Swabhavata eva means naturally I will be there. Na itareshu. Because they come to me. So here, of course, there is one commentator like Ramaraya. He proposes a small, Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha means a question. So you are giving the example of Agni. Agni, of course, is very parichinna. Agni is totally limited, isn't it? But this Bhagavan is aparichinna. Bhagavan is everywhere. Your satta spuranam, your satyam jnanam anantam is everywhere, isn't it? So how can you give the example of that Agni which is parichinna? When somebody comes near me, I will help. Somebody is not coming near me, I will not help. How is it? So then again he gives a reply. Because it is true that Bhagavan is there in every place, but then in your own antahkarana you are not able to see it. So that is it. It is there in you, you are not able to see it. So Agni example is rather a physical example where you can say that it is parichinna. So this is, he gives the reply is, Bhagavan is there everywhere, but then due to ajnana, due to ignorance, we are not able to see that. So that is why I am not able to help them. If they see me in their antahkarana, I will help them. If they cannot see me at all, then I cannot help. So that is the meaning. Is it okay? If they see me, did you understand this Purvapaksha also? Purvapaksha is, Agni, you are giving a physical example, but God, how can he be such a limited entity, something like Agni? So that is why the reply given is, God is no doubt everywhere, God is in every antahkarana. You have to realize, if you are ignorant and if you are not able to realize the presence of that, Bhagavan, then he cannot help you. If you realize, he can help you. So that is the explanation given. Teshu chapyam swabhavata eva varte na itareshu, not in others. Naitavata, naitavata is na etavata, na plus etavata, merely by this. Naitavata is merely by this. Na teshu dveshaha mama, I don't have any hatred for them. So that is the, 29th, any other point? Okay, that's all. Okay, next let us go to Shrunu Mat Bhakteer Mahatmyam. Okay, Bhaktehe Mahatmyam. You see the greatness of my, you listen to the greatness of my Bhakti. Bhakti to me. You see the greatness, if you have that Bhakti, you see what great results it will give. So that is it. Let us read the shloka.
Api chet suduracharo
bhajate. Bhajate maam ananya bhak. Sadhureva samantavyah. Samyagvyavasito hi saha. So we are here talking about sudurachara. Durachara. We know what is durachara. Achara is whatever conduct is there, good conduct is there. Achara, vyavahara, whatever good conduct is there. Durachara, one whose conduct is not according to dharma, not according to the social norms, let us say, not according to the social norms. Durachara. Sudurachara, sushtu durachara. Su means very, very extremely bad. So that is sushtu durachara. Sushtu durachara means somebody who does not follow any social norms, nor say all these things, any sort of fixed procedures, let us say. Such a person, api chet sudurachara, bhajate maam ananya bhak. Maam sushtu durachara api bhajate chet. The anvaya is like that. Maam sudurachara api bhajate chet. So that chet has to be brought like this. The chet has to be brought to bhajate chet. So even if a durachara, even if somebody who is not conforming to any norms, who is not conforming to any social standards, if he worships me, how? Ananya bhak. Ananya bhak means that ananya bhakti. We have to remember that ananya bhakti. That is, I am not different from that self. I am not, myself is not different from that supreme. That is, in that sense, if he loves me like that, if he is a jnani, and even according to loka drishti, means in the perception of all the people, he is not following any norm, he is not doing sandhya vandana, he is not doing yajna, he is not doing any yaga, he is just indifferent, he is just moving like a madcap. So we come across such characters in Bhagavata. For example, they are called avadhutas. Avadhuta means one who has just given up, one who has shaken off everything. Avadhuta. Dhuta means one who has shaken off everything. Avadhuta. So those people who have just shaken off all bonds, who have shaken off all rules and all that, and then who just eat everything. For example, Ramakrishna, Paramahamsa, he was said to be eating even dung. And then he was going to some houses of the Dalits. At that time, totally untouchable, and at that time, totally ostracized from society. So he used to go to their houses, he used to clean their houses. So he is a Durachara, strictly speaking, isn't it? From the point of view of the world, he was a Durachara. So such people, apiches sadhu sudurachara, he is not talking about criminals who do hardcore crimes. He is talking about achara, not crimes. So bhajate mam ananya bhag sadhureva samantavya. He has to be treated as sadhu. He should be considered a sadhu. So maybe in those days, at that time, so the jnanis, they were so totally, some people who had reached that level of avadhuta, they were not bothered about any of these, all the local, customs, habits and all these things. And then, suppose the society is trying to denigrate them, society is trying to treat them as some unwanted people. So from that point of view, this is a shloka which tells, so if he is a jnani, if he is really an ananya bhak, his idea or his understanding of the divinity is perfect. His resolution, that is samyag vyavasitaha, vyavasitaha. What is vyavasitaha? We have come across this word earlier. Vyavasayatmika buddhi rekeha kurunandana bahushakha hyanantascha buddhayo avyavasayinam. There in that second adhyaya, vyavasayatmika buddhi, we have come across. Vyavasayatmika means that which has got a proper understanding, that which has got viveka, that which has proper decision making, that is what is called vyavasaya. Vyavasaya is good resolution. Good resolution, good decision making, that is vyavasaya. Samyag vyavasitaha. So this man is well resolved. He has made proper decision. He has made the right decision. Samyag vyavasitaha. He has made the right decision. He has a right understanding about the divinity. So that is why he should be treated as sadhu. Sadhureva samantavyaha. So this is one way of saying. Or suppose you say that durachara, for the word durachara you say, really he is doing certain bad things. Suppose you take that meaning. Then the second shloka, Shipram Bhavati Dharmatma, is going to give the answer. So even if he is doing some bad deeds, he will give up those bad deeds the moment he comes to me. So that second shloka we will read later. Suppose for this shloka which we are reading at present, suppose you give the meaning as a jnani who is not following certain social norms, the meaning is perfectly okay. Suppose you give a very literal meaning and say somebody who is doing some sort of erratic things and then some bad things, then also you can say the next shloka will give answer saying that man will come to the right path because he is following me, he is having a proper understanding about the divinity. So in any way you can interpret. So okay. So for example, Madhusudana Saraswati and other people, they have interpreted in the sense of a jnani only. So let us read the, is the shloka clear? Api chet sudurachara, sudurachara, mam bhajate chet. That is the anvaya. Ananyabhaksan, ananyabhaksan, mam yadi bhajati chet. Saha sadhu huyeva mantavyaha. He should be treated or he should be considered as a sadhu. He should be treated as a right, person. Because samyak vyavasitaha, he is having the right resolution. He has made the right decision. Then,
Api chet
yadyapi
sushtu duracharaha sudurachara
ativa kutsitacharopi bhajate mam
ananya bhak ananya bhaktissan
samyak vrutayeva samantavyaha
jnatavyaha samyak yathavat
vyavasitaha
hi yasmat
sadhu nischayaha saha okay. Api chet means even if sushtu duracharaha, sudurachara, ativa kuchitacharaha. That is somebody who is just not following any social norms. Kuchitacharaha. Somebody who is not following any shaucham, not following any madi as we call it. So all these things he is not observing. So he is violating all these things. He is not doing upavasa, that is fast on Ekadashi. He is not doing upavasa on some other day. And then when there is grahanam, he is eating all types of prohibited things he is doing. So such man, even if that is so, bhajate mam ananya bhak ananya bhaktissan. That is ananya bhaktissan, without that feeling of duality. He is not different. This the supreme thing is not different from me. With that sort of say understanding, if he is there with me, then sadhureva samyak vrutta eva. Sadhu means samyak vruttaha. Vruttam means conduct. Vrutta is conduct. Vartate, the same vartate root gives result, gives rise to all these words. Vartate, vrutti, vruttaha. So all these things. Vruttaha means one who has that character. Samyag vruttaha, one who is having a good character. Samyag vrutta eva samantavyaha, he should be known, jnatavyaha. Samyak yathavat vyavasitaha. Vyavasitaha means resolved, well resolved. Then he, yasmat, because sadhu nishchayaha saha. Sadhu nishchayaha means he has made the right decision. Sadhu nishchaya, that is right decision. He has made the correct decision. So in this shloka, suppose you take the second meaning, a different meaning. That is somebody who is doing some irregular things. There again, one commentator gives the examples from Mahabhagavata. In Mahabhagavata, there are certain characters like Ajayamila. Ajayamila was a robber. Ajayamila is a robber who comes in contact with, who becomes a devotee, and then who gives up all those things and then who attains moksha. So, the such stories are there. Valmiki is one. So, like that, let us see the next shloka. Kshipram bhavati dharmatma. Shashvat shantim nigacchati. Kaunteya pratijanihi. Name bhakta pranasyati. Okay. So you suppose you take the second meaning. Then this continuation is kshipram bhavati dharmatma. Kshipram means immediately. Kshipram, shigram. Kshipram means shigram. That is immediately. Bhavati dharmatma. He will become a person with righteous deeds. He will become person with right dharmatma. Dharmanusari. So he will become dharmacharanaha, dharmanusari. So he will become somebody with a good conduct. Then shashvat shantim nigachati. Shashvat means always. Shashvat, shashvata. Shashvata comes from that. Shashvat shantim nigachati. So he gets that shashvata shanti. Nigachati is attains. He attains that thing. Then kaunteya, he kaunteya. Pratijanihi. Pratijanihi, you know the word pratijna. What is pratijna? Pratijna means you make a sworn statement, isn't it? Pratijna is something you make a sworn statement. Yes, I will do this. So that is a sworn statement, isn't it? That is what is called pratijna. So pratijanihi is you do pratijna. You do pratijna on my behalf. You do pratijna on my behalf. You loudly and proudly proclaim everywhere. You proclaim everywhere, challenge and proclaim everywhere. That is the meaning of pratijanihi. You go and proclaim everywhere. Na me bhakta pranasyati. My bhakta will never go to doom. Na me bhakta, my bhakta will never pranasyati. He will never go to doom. So that is, he will never perish. So let us see the bhashyam. Utsrujyacha bahyam duracharatam. Antas samyag vyavasaya samarthyat. Okay, this is utsrujya bahyam duracharatam. This duracharata is bahya. This is only related to the body only. Bahya durachara, you are not fasting. It is bahya durachara. Internally you are okay. This is bahya duracharata, isn't it? Utsrujya means leaving, casting away. Utsrujya is casting away or leaving all that bahyam duracharatam. Antaha samyag vyavasaya samarthyat. Antaha, inside, samyak vyavasaya samarthyat. Because of the strength of the right resolution made inside. So that is it. Because of vyavasaya samarthyat. Samarthya means strength. Because of the strength of the right resolution which is there in his mind. Because of that, What does he become? Shipram shigram bhavati.
Shipram shigram bhavati.
Dharmaatma dharmachitta eva.
Dharmaatma dharmachitta eva.
Shashvat nityam.
Shashvat nityam.
Shantim cha upashamam.
Shantim cha upashamam.
Nigacchati prapnoti.
Nigacchati prapnoti.
So that's such a man. Shigram bhavati dharmaatma. He becomes a dharmachitta eva. Even if he were to be a sort of a renegade, if somebody who is having some sort of renegade behavior, renegade is a negative word, he is just not following certain norms, let us say, even if he is doing all that durachara, that bahya duracharata is there, but antahkaran on the inside, his resolution is right. So for such a man, he will give up all those things. Shashvat shantim upashamam cha nigachati. He will immediately attain. He will attain that shanti upashamam. He will attain that upashama is the basic result of jnana only. Upashama comes only when jnana is there. When jnana is not there, that shanti is not there. So long as jnana is not there, a man will be highly agitated. When jnana is there, he will have peace. He will have what is called upashama. So these two things are interdependent, isn't it? A cultivation of upashama will lead to jnanam. Jnanam will automatically give upashama. These are interrelated. Then upashamam nigachati means prapnoti. He attains that shanti. So here, of course, kincha shashvat nityam shantim vishayabhoga nispruha nivruttim nigachati. Vishayabhoga spruha nivruttim. Of course, Madhusudana Saraswati gives the meaning of shanti as vishayabhoga spruha nivruttihi. That is, so he loses all interest in all these sensual pleasures. Vishayabhoga spruha nivrutti. That is, he gives up, he loses, not even gives up, he loses. Giving up is different and losing is different. Giving up is, though that lingering desire is there, you are forcibly keeping it away. Nivrutti means those desires, they don't enter your mind at all. So that is a better stage, isn't it? So that nivrutti, that is, all those things, they never arise in his mind. Vishayabhoga. So that sort of situation he attains. Then shrunu paramartham kaunteya.
Shrunu paramartham kaunteya.
Pratijanihi nishitam pratignyam kuru.
Pratijanihi nishitam pratignyam kuru.
Name bhaktaha, name mama bhaktaha.
Name mama bhaktaha.
Mayi samarpitantaratma madbhaktaha.
Mayi samarpitantaratma madbhaktaha.
Na pranashyati iti.
Na pranashyati iti.
Okay, hey kaunteya, shrunu paramartham. You listen to the supreme truth. Paramartham, you listen to the supreme truth. Pratijanihi nishitam pratignyam kuru. You make a firm declaration. You make a bold declaration. Announcement rather. You make a bold announcement. What is that? Name bhaktaha. Who is this bhakta? Mayi samarpita antaratma. One whose antaratma, one who is antahkarana is in me. Mayi samarpita antaratma. One whose antaratma is antahkarana. Is in me, that is one who is dwelling in that Brahmakara vritti, in whose mind he is seeing Brahman everywhere, that Brahmakara vritti is there, and then one who is in that state, a person like that, name bhaktaha pranashyati, he will never perish. Is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, kincha.
Kincha.
Where is this? Okay. Maam hi partha vyapashritya.
Maam hi partha vyapashritya.
Yepisyuh papayonayah.
Yepisyuh papayonayah.
Striyo vaishyastatha shudrah.
Striyo vaishyastatha shudrah.
Tepiyanti param gatim.
Tepiyanti param gatim.
Okay, maam hi partha vyapashritya. He partha. Maam vyapashritya. Vyapashritya means ashritya. V plus apa plus ashritya. Vyapashritya, ashritya, one and the same. That is, having taken shelter under me or being my bhaktas. Maam vyapashritya. Ye pi syuhu papayonaha. Ye janaha papayonayaha syuhu. Even those who are papa yonayaha. What is the meaning of papa yonayaha? Papam yonihi yesham te papa yonayaha. Yoni means reason, the karanam. Papam is the karanam or the origin. Yoni is the origin or karanam. those for whom papam is karanam, they are called papayonayaha. Those for whom papam is karanam, that is born out of sin, let us say, born out of papam, papayonayaha, born out of papam. So papayonayaha papam yonihi yeshante papayonayaha, that is those who have done some bad deeds in earlier lives, and then in this life they are born as some krimi, ketaka, all those insects or some birds or some other animals or some lowly animals or something like that. So for this word papayonaya, of course, two meanings are given by different commentators. One is Papa Shankaracharya, of course, he has not mentioned any, he has not given anything. Papa janmanaha, he only said papa janmanaha, those who are having sinful births, papa janmanaha, he says. Then other people have given other meanings, like, for example, Madhusudana Saraswati writes antyajaha. Antyajaha means those we are having this the so-called division, this varna, chaturvarnya division. And in this chaturvarnya, also beyond this chaturvarnya, there is what is called antyaja. So those who belong to the last category. So Madhusudana Saraswati gives that meaning. Then in this particular case, I read many other bhashyams also. Because this is a slightly controversial line, it can be misinterpreted. It can be misinterpreted, particularly the second line can be seriously misinterpreted. So that is why I read another Vyakhya called Sridhari Vyakhya. Sridhari Vyakhya, Sridharacharya is another great Advaita Vedanti who has written a very beautiful commentary on Bhagavatam. Sridhari Vyakhya on Mahabhagavatam is very famous. On Gita also he has written. Then another commentator is there in this book, Abhinava Guptacharya. Abhinava Gupta is a Kashmiri pandit. He was a Shaiva pandit, Abhinava Gupta. He was a great Alankarika. He was a very great rhetorician. So that person, he was also a philosopher. He was a Vedanti. So he has also written a commentary on Gita. So I am quoting from those things also. So here, Papa Yonayaha, Nikrushta Janmanaha Antyajaha. That is what Sridhara writes. Sridharacharya writes, Nikrushta Janmanaha, those who are having some lowly existence, those who are Antyajaha. Now what you call Dalita or scheduled caste or something like that, must be something like that. Then Abhinava Gupta writes, Papayonayaha Pashu Pakshi Sarishrupadayaha. Pashu means animal. Pakshi, some bird, Sarisrupam, something like some serpents and all these crawling animals. Sarisrupa, they are all these crawling animals. So, Papayonayaha, Pashu, Pakshi, Sarisrupadayaha. So, this is the meaning given by Abhinava Gupta. This difference we have to note, basically to see how this word can be, interpreted. So, for example, Akhandananda Saraswati, very famous Swamiji. What he said, that also I will explain. I will explain slowly. So here for this word papayonayaha, two meanings have been given. One is pashupakshyadayaha, the second meaning is antyajaha. Then, of course, there is also a tendency to connect this papayonaya with the second line. You see the second line, yepisyuh papayonayaha, ye papayonayaha syuhu, that is those who may be, syuhu is in that tense, is those who may be papayonayaha. Who are they? It can be connected like that. They are Striyaha, Vaishyaha, Tatha Shudraha. So it is referring to that. Stri, Vaishya and Shudra, are they really Papayonayaha? Have they made some sin in the earlier birth and are they now born as women, Vaishya and Shudra? So there is a tendency, by this construction of this shloka, you can interpret that way also. You can interpret that way also, but most of the commentators have split that Papayonaya and the second line. Papayonaya has nothing to do with second line, that is Sriyaha, Vaishya, Sudra, etc. It is not as though all these threes have done Papam and then born as women. It is not as though the Vaishyas, they have committed some sin and then they are born in this as Vaishyas. It is not as though all the Shudras, they have done some sin and then they are born as Shudras. It is not like that. So, Papayonaya has no connection with Sriyo, Vaishya, Tatha, Shudraha. That is what Akhandananda Saraswati says. Akhandananda Saraswati, he is also following these people only. Madhusudana Saraswati, Sridhariya and Abhinava Gupta. These people have disconnected that word Papayonaya from the second line. If you don't disconnect, it will give a very bad meaning, which can never be accepted even by Shankaracharya. Because Shankaracharya, he has himself written in the Chaturvarnyam Maya Sushtam Gunakarma Vibhagashaha, because this shloka has to be read along with, in the overall context of Gita and in the overall context of Mahabharatam. In the overall context of Mahabharatam, it always says that this Varna is dependent on Guna, isn't it? Chaturparanyamaya Srushtam Guna Karma Vibhagasha. Guna Brahmana Sattva Pradhanatvat Brahmana. Then this fellow, this Kshatriya, then Tama Upasarjana Raja, Raja Pradhanasya. Tama Upasarjana Raja Pradhanasya Kshatriyasya. So that is what we read. This Rajoguna is dominant there. Then Rajoguna in a different sense is dominating in Vaishya. Rajoguna in the sense of money. So Rajoguna in the sense of power is dominant in Kshatriya. Rajoguna in the sense of money is dominant in Vaishya. Then Tamoguna is dominant in other person, Shudra. And in fact, the meaning of Shudra also we have to note. Shucha Vidravati iti Shudra. Shucha Vidravati. Suppose there is a situation. If there is a situation, the fellow who boldly faces it is a Kshatriya. Isn't it? A situation, if there is a challenge, he boldly faces it. He is a Kshatriya. Then Adra Vidravati, Sucha Vidravati, that is, he gets scared and runs away from that. So that sort of situation is actually called Shudra. The etymological meaning of Shudra is one who becomes timid and runs away. One who becomes timid and runs away. We are not referring to somebody who calls himself a Shudra now. We are referring to a characteristic. We should not say that all the people whom we find as Shudras, they are like that. All the people whom we find as Kshatriyas, they are very bold and all that. All the Brahmanas are highly virtuous and all that. It is not so. A Brahmana can be a Shudra if he is afraid of everything every day. A Brahmana, he is showing a Shudra mentality. That is Shudratvam or timidness or running away from a situation if he is scared every day of everything. So Brahmana is supposed to coolly think. He is supposed to coolly know the nature of a problem. He is supposed to coolly analyze a problem. Only then he is a Brahmana. And the Kshatriya is a chap who will face it. So that is the guna. We are referring to the guna. So this word Papayonaya, Akhandananda Saraswati says, should not be connected with this second line. That is Sriyo Vaishyas Tatha Shudraha. He also gives Shruti reference. For example, there is one line in the Upanishad, Brihadaranyaka only. What is this? Ramaniya charanaha ramaniyam yoni mapadyante, kapuya charanaha kapuyam yoni mapadyaran. That is, ramaniya charanaha, that is, those who are having good charitra. Charitra means conduct, good behavior, good performance. Who do all virtuous deeds. Okay, let us use that. That is the right word. Those who are virtuous, Ramaniya Charanaha, those who are virtuous people, they get good births, good virtuous birth or virtuous lives. Ramaniya Charanaha, Ramaniyam Yoni Mapadhyaran. That is, they will have a good, future Janma. And Kapuya Charanaha, those who have all this filthy conduct, those who have got sinful conduct, they get into some sinful lokas. Then for Ramaniyam Yonim Apadhyaran, the Brahmana Yonimva, Kshatriya Yonimva, Vaishya Yonimva, that is also mentioned there. Vaishya, we should know that Vaishya also is a Dvija. I have explained earlier, when you say Dvija, it refers to not Brahmin alone, it refers to Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya, all the three. So Vaishya is not somebody who has to be dismissed. He is also having Vedadhikara. So, but why here it is in this line, why this Lord Krishna is mentioning here? Because it is mentioned in the Bhashyam, Vaishyaha Krushyadi Matra Rataha, then Krushyadi Karmantara Rataha. So, the fellows who are engaged, those people who are engaged in Krushi and then they are not able to spend time on Vedadhyana, those who are not able to spend time on, Atma Vichara. So, in that sense we have to take, not as though By birth stree is debarred, by birth some Vaishya is debarred, by birth some Shudra is debarred. Now here we are seeing, what we have to see is the guna and not the birth. So that is what we have to remember here. So because Shankaracharya himself will go, he will not go against Shruti, isn't it? Lord Krishna again, he is the man who is from whom all the Shruti has come. Then Shankaracharya will not go against the Shruti. So that is why we have to take into consideration that line, Ramaniya Charanaha Ramaniyam Yoni Mapadhyaran. In that example given is also Vaishya. Vaishya also is a person who is a Ramaniya Charana. So that is why he is having that Vedadhyayana Adhikara. But then because he is busy with all this krushi, all the cultivation and all these things, krushi, goraksha, manijyam, vaishyakarma, swabhavajam, we are going to see in 18th chapter. That is krushi, cultivation, goraksha, cattle rearing, then vanijyam, business, trade. So it is not only trade. When you say vaishya, you are not referring to only trade. You are referring to all this social activity, that is cultivation and then goraksha, cattle rearing. So that is how Krishna vajay vaishya, strictly speaking. Krishna vajay gopala, isn't it? So likewise, so all these people, they will attain param gatim. You come back to the shloka. Maam vyapashritya yepi papayonayaha syuhu, those who may be papayonayaha or Striyaha, Vaishyaha, Tatha Shudraha. They may be women, they may be Vaishyaha, Tatha Shudraha, Tepi Yanti Paramgatim. They also will attain Paramgatim. They will attain that supreme thing. Striyaha. Stri, normally, why this mention of Stri is, Stri, she may be a Brahmana Stri, she may be a Kshatriya Stri, whatever it is. She is engaged in all household work. Engaged in household work, exceptionally, there are some exceptions whom we find in Upanishads. People like Gargi, who has some sort of Shastra Charcha with Yajnavalkya. Then this man's Yajnavalkya's wife himself, she follows Yajnavalkya, and then she wants to know Brahmajnana. So we see in Upanishads women doing this Brahma Vichara and all that. So in Bharata and Mahabharatam also we come across several examples of women who are very well versed in Shastras. So but then this is in a very, very general sense it is said that these people who are not exposed to Shastra studies. So in that sense we have to take, not that women are ignorant or women are having low IQ or any such thing. It is not like that. Striyo Vaishyas, Vaishyas, we have to remember that Vaishya is a Dvija. And Vaishya is supposed to be a Ramaniya Charana. Ramaniya Charana means those who have done virtuous deeds and then having a virtuous birth. Virtuous deed will lead you to a virtuous birth. So that is it. Vaishyas Tatha Shudraha Tepiyanti Paramgatim. Is this shloka okay?
Yes.
Okay, then Maam hi esmat partha vyapashritya maam ashrayatvena gruhitva yepi syuhu bhaveyuhu papayonayaha papajanmanaha. Okay. So, maam vyapashritya, mama ashrayatvena gruhitva, maam ashrayatvena gruhitva, having taken me as refuge, having come to me, having reposed there, faith in me, not exactly faith, having recognized that supreme self, supreme being. So, like those people, yepi syuhu, syuhu means bhaveyuhu, those who may be, papayonayaha, who are those papayonayaha? By virtue of some previous bad deeds, they might have got some janma, like pashu janma, pachi janma, etc., etc. So those pachi janma, papa, Shankaracharya is not giving, he has not given the example for that. Papani yonihi yesham te papa yonayaha. Papam is the karanam or origin for them. So those people are called papa yonayaha. Papa janmanaha. So do you have this word also, ke te ityaha?
Yes.
This kete ityaha. So here in Shankara Bhashyam, the papajanmana, papayonayaha is connected with the second line. Papayonayaha is connected as adjective for the second line. So which means that maybe Shankaracharya could not have written this. That is what Ankhandananda Saraswati says, because Shankaracharya will not go against Shruti. Shankaracharya could not have written this. Maybe this is some sort of some enthusiastic person could have written this sort of kete, this linking up. Because all other people, they have not written. Madhusudana Saraswati has not written. Sridharacharya has not written. Abhinava Guptacharya has not written. All these people have disconnected that papayonaya from the second line. So in the Shankara Bhashya, this connected papayonaya, kete, who are those papayonaya? He is giving the example of Sriyaha, Vaishya, Shudra, etc. And certainly, we have to agree with Akhandananda also, because he follows Madhusudana Saraswati, Sridhara and also Abhinava Gupta, who have disconnected this papayoni from the second line. So this is what we have to remember. स्त्रियः वैश्यास्तथा शूद्राः तेपि यान्ति गच्छन्ति परां गतिं प्रकृष्टां गतिं। ओके, दिस् इस् सिम्पल्। स्त्रियः वैश्याः, एक्स्प्लेन्ड् वाट् इस् वैश्य। वैश्य इस् हि इस् ए द्विज, हि हेस् गाट् एक्टिविटि आफ् कृषि गोरक्ष वाणिज्यम्, हि इस् एण्टैटिल्ड् फार् वेदिक् स्टडीस्, सो दोस् पीपल्। बट् देन् इन् दिस् पर्टिक्युलर् केस् मे बि इट् इस् रेफर्डिङ्ग् टु because he is engaged in krushi goraksha vanijyam, he is engaged in so much of activity, he is not having time to study. So in that sense, then shudraha, again those who are engaged in this seva vritti, all these service activities, and then who are not having time, who are not having time to study these things, then all those people also param gatim prakushtam gatim. Once if they realize me, that is, if they realize that there is something which is some supreme being, then they will attain that supreme status. Then let us read this shloka. kim punar brahmanah punya bhakta rajarshayastatha anityam asukham lokam imam prapya bhajasvamam. So what to talk of when you say that, okay, even such people will attain punya, even those who are papayonayah, even those who are study Vedas, who are not able to do all these studies and attain all that education, even they, if they worship me, they will attain moksha. When I say that, what to talk of punaha brahmana kim punaha, what to talk of brahmanaha punyaha, those people who are engaged in brahmajnana. Brahmanaha, here again we have to take it as those who are engaged, that their pravritti is in doing brahmavichara, then punyaha, who are also doing good deeds, who are doing virtuous deeds, then bhaktaha rajarshayastatha, this rajarshayaha. Rajarshi is, we have come across this word in the fourth chapter, Rajanaschate Rushayaha, those who are jnanis, the jnanis like King Janaka, etc. So those people, and also bhaktas, they are also devotees. King Janaka was a great bhakta. Similarly, we come across Mahabhagavatam, where there are so many kings who are very great bhaktas. So all those people, then anityam asukham lokam imam prapya bhajasvamam. So what to talk of all these people? Then anityam asukham lokam, this loka, what is this loka? We are talking about ihaloka. We are talking about this lokam. This is human janma, manushya janma. Loka does not refer to bhumi. Loka does not necessarily refer to bhumi. It is referring to janma, manushya janma. Shankaracharya actually is giving that meaning. Lokam manushya lokam. Manushya loka is manushya janma. Lokyante iti lokani, isn't it? Lokyate iti lokaha janma, lokyante iti lokani janmani. That is what he clarifies in another place. What is that? Ishavasya Bhashyam. Loka means a janma. Manushya, this loka means this manushya janma. So, anityam asukham lokam, this particular lokam, this manushya janma, what type of thing it is? Anityam, it is non-eternal. Then asukham, it is not very happy, it is rather miserable. This thing, prapya, having attained it, or having come into this, now you bhajasva mam, you be after me only, you be attached to me, you be devoted to me. So that is the meaning. Is the rhyme over?
One more minute.
Okay. So this shloka is, kim punaha, what to talk of? When you are saying that even those people will attain moksha, what to talk of these virtuous people? Let us read one line. Kim punar brahmanaha punyaha,
punyaha punyayonayaha
bhaktaha rajarshayastatha rajanaschate rushayascha iti rajarshayaha. Okay, kim punaha, what to talk of those brahmanaha, punyaha, punyayonayaha, as opposed to that papayonayaha, these are all punyayonayaha, those who have done various virtuous deeds and then who have come to this stage. Then rajarshayaha, bhaktaha, those devotees, rajarshayastatha, rajanaschate rushayaha, those who are wise kings. Yata evam mataha. Anityam kshanabhanguram. Asukham cha. Sukhavarjitam imam. Imam lokam manushya lokam prapya. Purushartha sadhanam. Durlabham manushyatvam labdhva. Bhajasva sevasva mam. So this manushya loka you have attained. So that is yatayeva mataha, because of this anityam kshanabhanguram asukham. Kshanabhanguram, it is just momentary. Kshanam is moment. Kshanabhanguram is momentary. Asukham, that which doesn't give you any sukha. Sukha varjitam, that is devoid of any sukha. Imam lokam, that is manushya lokam prapya. We know that this manushya loka or the human body or the human life is the only stage where a person can do a good karma, isn't it? Here, this is what is called the karma bhumi. Karma bhumi does not refer to India. Karma bhumi refers to the human life, where a person can do good deeds and then he can promote himself. If he does some bad deeds, he degrades himself, he goes down. So that is the loka. Then purushartha sadhanam durlabham manushyatvam labdhva. Manushyatvam is the purushartha sadhanam. So anyway, we'll explain. I think it's better to explain in the next class. Purushartha sadhanam. We know this purushartha, dharmartha, kama, moksha. For all these purusharthas, the sadhanam is the human body only. So that is it. We will see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.